Alors en Nouvelle-Zélande, qu'est-ce qu'il y a? Il y a des chevaux, mais il y a aussi des rugbymen, des All Blacks. Eh bien, figurez-vous qu'aux ventes de Karaka, nous en avons trouvé un. Un ancien rugbyman, super vedette internationale, c'est Sims Davison et aujourd'hui il est vendeur. Allez, va nous expliquer un peu. Hello Sims.
Hello, hey gang.
How are you today?
Great, great. Yeah.
What are you doing? It's finished for you, the rugby, that's it?
Rugby is over and now selling horses. So I finished up rugby and then came home to run the family farm. So it's been a very exciting time, very busy last few years, but been really great.
Can you explain a little bit what is Mapperless Stud? Is that where was bred, so you think?
Yes, so so Mapperless Stud's just it's been in the family for three generations, so I'm the third generation to come home and take over it. So we've had a lot of fantastic horses come off the farm, so you think, it's a done deal, Monica Console. It's a beautiful property, it's one of the oldest properties with studs in New Zealand, so it's been a fantastic opportunity for me to come home and take over a family business like that, and a lot of pressure because it's been around for a few generations and hopefully it can be around for a few more as well if I do everything right.
So when you were young, you were not following the horse business, but you moved to rugby. Can you explain that? Can you explain a little bit your career?
Went away to boarding school and then started obviously playing rugby, and it sort of led on to that. I was reasonably good at it, and before I knew it, I was playing. Playing professional rugby, it happened very, very quickly as a young age, and unfortunately, playing professional rugby and been, you know, working on the farm just couldn't do it. So it was really great to actually go out and, you know, and play rugby around the world, and then to come back. And I think it was a good time when I finished up playing rugby to come back to the farm. I obviously had some worldly experiences, and being able to come back to the farm with fresh ideas, it was really exciting.
Can you explain the activity of Mapperley? How wide is it? A little bit of the structure?
Yeah, sure. Mapperley Studs are 650 acres. We run about 350 horses on the place. When I came back from playing rugby, it was just adjustment. So we just did brood mares and brought yearlings to the sales. We had no stallions. But the stallions were something I was very passionate in, and that's something we've got into since I've been home. We've gone out and got four really nice stallions, and we syndicated amongst a lot of breeders. So it's quite exciting. This year we've got two of our first season sires, Contributor, who was a champion middle distance horse in Australia, and also another horse called Complacent. So quite an exciting year for me.
To finish, will you help your sons to be a rugby player or to be farmers?
Whatever, they're pretty rugby bad at the moment, so I'd say they all want to be rugby players, and then if they're too slow or not good enough, I'd say they'll come back to the farm after that. But I think every young Kiwi boy, the first thing I want to be is a rugby player. And so I'll go give it a crack, no doubt, and then at some stage hopefully they'll come back to the farm and help Dad out.